today we have to see meaning for Shiva Panchakshara Nakshatra Malika Stotram from shloka number 18. Let's see. ईहिताक्षणप्रदानहेतवे नमः शिवाय आहिताग्निपालकोक्षकेतवे नमः शिवाय देहकान्तिधूतरौप्यधातवे नमः शिवाय गेहदुःखपूज्यधूमकेतवे नमः शिवाय. द फर्स्ट लाइन इज ईहित क्षण प्रदान हेतवे नमः शिवाय. ईहित ईक्ष इट मीन्स डिजायर. ईहित क्षण प्रदान हेतवे वाट एवर वी डिजायर भगवान परमेश्वरा इज केपेबल ऑफ फुलफिलिंग द डिजायर इन अ क्षण. इट डजंट टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम फॉर हिम टू डू एनीथिंग. संकल्प मात्रेण जस्ट बै doing mere sankalpam, just by doing mere sankalpam, he fulfills the wishes of his devotees. Ihita kshana pradana hetave. Next line is ahita agni pala koksha ketave namah shivaya. Ahita agni pala, pala pa to protect. Who is he protecting? He protects someone called as ahita agni. Ahitagni is a technical name for people who does yajnams, like Soma Yajnam and all. According to Shastra, every person has to undergo 40 samskaras. What are samskaras? Samskaras are rituals, like Kumsavanam, Simandam. You know, before giving birth, the mother undergoes Kumsavanam, ritual called as Kumsavanam and Simandam for giving birth, you know, for giving birth to a healthy baby. And after the baby is born, a ritual called as Jatakarma was done. Jatakarma is usually done. Then after Jatakarma, we do Annaprasanam, Namakaranam, etc. Annaprasanam is ritually we are giving food to the people. Namakaranam, we are naming the kid. You know, Jatakarma, Namakaranam, Annaprasanam. Then Chaulam. Chaulam is ritually keeping the tuft, kudmi, which is called Chaulam. And then Upanayanam. Upanayanam, we all know. Upanayanam is punal putkarthu, you know, having Yajnopavitam. Each and everything is called as samskaras because it is for purification of the body and mind. And normally, all the people that we see, they only do 19 samskaras. If you actually count out of 40, only 19 samskaras are being done today. Then what about the remaining 21 samskaras? Those 21 samskaras are divided into groups of 7. 7 plus 7 plus 7 equal to 21, right? So those 21 samskaras are grouped into groups of 7 and these are called as yajnas. So yajna, whatever we do, Ganapati Homam and all, it is not Shrauta Yajna. Whatever we do, it is called as Smartha Yajnas because it is told in Smriti. What are called as Shrauta Yajnas are fire rituals that have been prescribed by Vedas themselves. Vedas are called as Shrutis, and because these Yajnas have their origin in Vedas, Shrutis, these Yajnas are called as Shrauta Yajnas. So the first group of 7 are called as Paka Yajnas. I'm just telling you because we are all supposed to do this, but we don't do this. At least we learn the names of the yajnas. The first 7 yajnas are called as paka yajnas. Paka means food, pachati, to cook. So these yajnas are done with cooked food, paka yajnas. And the next 7 yajnas or called as Havir Yajna. Havihi, Havis means cooked rice. So these seven yajnas are done with cooked rice. That is why these yajnas are called as Havir Yajnas. And the last seven yajnas are called as Soma Yajnas. These yajnas are done with Soma. There is a mythical plant called as Soma herb. It is a herb or shrub. So with that Soma, they make juice of Soma. It is called as Soma Rasa. And when we do yajna with that Soma Rasa, these are called as Soma Yajna. And that is the last seven groups of Soma Yajna. You know, each yajna has got name. The names of seven paka yajnas are Ashtaka, Thalipaka, Parvana, Shravani, Agrahayani, Chaitri, Aswayuji. These are called as seven paka yajnas. The seven Havir yajnas are Agniadhana, Agnihotra, Darshapurnamasa, Agrayana, Chaturmasya, Niruda Pashupandha, and Sautramani. These are seven Havir Yajnas, and the seven Soma Yajnas are Agnishthoma, Atyagnishthoma, Uktya, Shodashi, Vajapeya, Atiratra, and Aptoryama. These are the names. We are not even, you know, aware of these seven Yajnas are there, these 21 Yajnas are there, and we are not aware of these names. So some of the names will come. Whenever we chant Rudra, we say Agnihotra Atmane Angushtabhyam Namaha, Darshapurnamasa Atmane Tarjani Bhyam Namaha, Chaturmasya Atmane Madhyama Bhyam Namaha, Virudhavashupanta Atmane Anamika Bhyam Namaha, Jyotishthoma Atmane Kanishthika Bhyam Namaha, Sarvakratva Atmane Karatalakara Prushta Bhyam Namaha. We do Nyasam by saying the names of these yajnas. Because Rudram itself, when we see the ritual aspect of Rudram, the portion of Vedas that has Rudram, it's mainly for doing yajnas. So Rudram is a mantra which is chanted during yajnas in Vedic days. And later time, Rishis have said, okay, Rudram, we are not doing all the yajnas now, at least chant Rudram. So when you chant Rudram, you get the punyam of doing all those yajnas. So Rudram is a yajna mantra. Why am I telling all these things is because it is related with Ahitagni. And the basis for all the 21 yajnas is the ritual called as Agnihotra. Agnihotra is the compulsory, is the prerequisite for doing all these 21 yajnas. And when do we do Agnihotra? Agnihotra is done from the time of marriage. Only when somebody is married, he is allowed to do Agnihotra. And only when Agnihotra is done, he can do all the yajnas. So marriage, having a wife, is very, very important to do all these things. In fact, whenever wife is not there, you know, when she has gone to another place or when she passes away, the person loses his right to do any of this 21 yajnas. The person will have Adhikara, the person has right over Agni only when in the presence of his wife. When wife is not present, he cannot do any of these yajnas, and that is the importance that is given to women in our Sanatana Dharma. Only when woman is there, only when wife is there, he can do all these yajnas. You know, we have seen this in Ramayana. When Sita has gone, Rama couldn't do the yajna. So Rama is Ekapatni Vrata. He will not marry again. So he has to make a golden Sita statue. And along with that statue, he did this yajna. So that much importance is given for the wife in Sanatana Dharma. And Agnihotra is the ritual. Agnihotra is the prerequisite for doing all these yajnas. And in the Agnihotra, Agnihotra is not an ordinary ritual. It has to be done daily, two times, one during sunrise and another during sunset. In one Agnihotra, a person has to worship three kinds of fire. It's called as Treta Agnihi. Agni means fire. Treta, three. Three types of fire one has to worship. It's called as Garhapatya, Ahavaniya. Namaste Garhapatyaya, Namaste Ahavaniyaya, Namaste Dakshinagni. The third type of Agni is called as Dakshinagni. Dakshinagni is for Pitrus. Garhapatya is the fire used to run family, like cooking and all. And Ahavaniya is for worshipping the Deva. So these three types of fire has to be maintained from a person's marriage. You know, the same Agni with which all the marriage ritual is done, that Agni will be divided into three, and that Agni will be maintained throughout one person's life, and when the person dies, he will be cremated with that Agni. So maintaining Agni, doing Agnihotra is not an easy job. It is a very big commitment, and still in India there are people who does these type of yajnas, who does Nitya Agnihotra. Nitya Agnihotra is doing Agnihotra daily. So they will be 24/7 maintaining the Agni. The Agni cannot be put off. When the Agni goes down, they have to do lot of prayaschitta to bring back the Agni, and he will be maintaining that Agni till his last breath. And when he dies, he will be burnt in that Agni. That kind of samskaras, even now in India, in Tamil Nadu, especially in Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, people are there doing all those yajnas, doing Nitya Agnihotri and all. And those people are called as Ahita Agnihi. So Ahita Agni are those type of people who maintains their Agnihotra Agni and does all these yajnas. And those people are called as Ahita Agnihi, and here Parameshwara is described as Ahita Agni Pala, the one who protects the Ahita Agni, because only when they do the yajna, we get all the rain. You know, Devatin Kural Mahapariva says, Durbhiksham Devalokeshu. In Devaloka, they cannot do any farming activities. They cannot cultivate rice. Only when people in the earth, when they do yajna, that becomes food for devas, and in turn devas give us rain to make more food, you know, to make the world prosperous. So whenever they do yajna, they are not doing for themselves, they are doing for everyone. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavantu, that is the motto of Sanatana Dharma, and that indeed is the motto of those people who do yajna. That is why, you know, in Kanchi Matam, they once in a year, they have a conference. They organize a sadas called as Agnihotra Sadas. Once in a year, I think during Chaturmasya Vratam of Acharyal, they organize a sadas called as Agnihotra Sadas, and they actually call all the Nitya Agnihotris to the mat, to the place where Acharya stays, and they do Agnihotra. You know, when 100 people are there, simultaneously 100 Agnihotram will happen in that area. It is a very sight to behold. It's a very good sight to behold. Whenever we get time, we should all go and do Namaskaram. And it is said that all the 33 crore Devatas are present in the Agnihotra Shala. In the Yajna Shala, all the 33 crore Devas are present. You know, you don't have to go to temple to do anything. You don't have to go to, you know, special Navagraha Kshetras to do any pariharas. Whenever we visit an Agnihotra Shala, whenever we do Namaskaram to that Ahita Agnihi, all these things will automatically come to us. And I have to tell you, the Ahita Agni, the Agnihotra ritual, the Yajna ritual, it has got so important. Even women normally are discouraged from chanting Vedas, right? Normally we say women cannot chant Vedas. Agnihotram and during Yajnam are the only two places where women can chant Vedas. If you go to a Yajna Shala, if you go to an Agnihotri's house, there are specified mantras where women, you know, the wife of that Yajamana, the Yajamana is the one who performs the Yajna, and the wife is called as Yajamani or Yajna Patni, and only at that time the Yajna Patni can chant Veda mantras herself. So that is the importance of doing Yajnas. And normally we do Abhivadaye, right? Whenever a boy has undergone Upanayanam, he will perform, whenever he does Namaskara to another Brahmana, another male, he chants his Pravara. In Tamil Nadu, it is called as telling Abhivadaye. I think in Andhra Sampradaya, it is called as telling Pravara. He will tell Pravara. And normally, you can tell Pravara to your mother and not to your father. And except for mother, you cannot tell Pravara to anyone, any woman. Only for men, you can chant Abhivade. You cannot chant Abhivade to sannyasis. You cannot chant Abhivade to devatas. When doing Namaskara in a temple, you should not chant Abhivade. There are so many lists are there. And for women, only for their own mother, one can chant Abhivade. One can tell Pravara. And normally for other women, we don't tell Abhivade. But the Dharma Sukshma here is that when you do Namaskara to an Yajna Patni, when you do Namaskara to the wife of the person who has done Yajna, she's called as Yajna Patni or Yajamani, you have to chant Abhivade. You have to tell your Pravara to her. So that is the importance of doing all these things. And these things are called as Ahita Agnihi, and Shiva protects those Ahita Agni. Ahita Agni Pala Koksha Ketave Namashivaya. Next line is Deha Kanti Dhuta Raupya Dhatave Namashivaya. Parameshwara's Deha, Parameshwara's body is so brilliant. Now, whenever we go to Arunachala, the name itself is Aruna and Achala. Aruna means bright red. You know, when you heat iron, after some time, it becomes so red, right? Parameshwara's body color is like that. In Tamil, they derive the name, they derive the meaning of Shiva like that. Sivandirundadanal Shivam. Sivandirundadu means red. Parameshwara is like burning red in color. That is why he is called as Shiva. You know, Mahapariva and Devatin Kural say, Parameshwara and burning has got lot in common. Parameshwara is bright red in color, like a burning piece of wood. And, you know, when a wood is burnt, you see nice red core. And Parameshwara's body is completely filled with ashes. Right? He is called as Bhasmadari. And what happens when you burn a wood? The core will be bright red and outside will be covered by the ashes. Parameshwara is often equated to Agni, and that is what here it says. Deha Kanti Bhuta Raupya Dhatave, the one whose Deha's Kanti, the one whose brilliance is in Deha, to him I offer my Namaskara. The fourth line is Geha Dukkha Pujya Dhuma Ketave Namashivaya. Parameshwara here, even now, it is Parameshwara is equated to a fire, but he destroys the dukkha. He destroys the miseries of this bhakta. That's why here he is called as Geha Dukkha Pujya Dhuma Ketave, the one, the fire that destroys all the miseries of this bhakta. To him, he offer my Namaskara. So with this, we will finish today's class.